In this paper, we will talk about map generation from high-quality imageries at large scale. What are the challenges and how we try to address them? First, let's look at the most widely available and publicly accessible labeled dataset, OpenStreetMap. Most populated areas like cities, houses, and roads are well labeled, but in rural areas, the roads are not aligned with the image. And in some suburban areas, houses are only partially labeled. Even in some populated cities, houses are not labeled at all. We try to address the inaccuracy in labeled data by using a feature-weighted cycle gun and incremental data augmentation, which we will talk in detail. The base cycle gun model uses two sets of generator and discriminator networks, and the two sets of networks are connected by a cycle consistency loss. We further added a feature-weighted loss on those pixels belonging to house and rows. The evaluation metric we used is a binary classification metric F1 score. As we know, the data label is not accurate or complete, but we do notice that once a house is labeled, it's likely to be accurate. So we put down the focus on recall score, which is the percentage of a house labeled being detected by the model. We studied four cities in Texas. Austin, Dallas has relatively more houses being labeled, while San Antonio and Houston have very limited house labels. Using Austin data, we showed that a feature-weighted cycle gun significantly improved the performance of a base cycle gun. Then we look at the generalization capability between feature-weighted cycle gun and the unit. Clearly, we showed the feature-weighted cycle gun generalized much better from one city to another. To further improve the performance, we introduce incremental data augmentation. By data augmentation, we first get the false positive house labels generated from feature-weighted cycle gun and add them back to the training dataset to form the augmented training dataset. By using the augmented training dataset, we have been able to significantly improve the performance of both feature-weighted cycle gun and unit, especially unit. For the Austin dataset, we achieved the recall score of 84.9%. To accelerate the training, we use decentralized parallel training method, which does not use a central parameter server and is less prone to straggler delay. In our experiment, we achieved a speedup of 14.7 utilizing 16 GPUs. We have made our result publicly accessible through the big data platform of PAIRS. To conclude, the incremental data augmentation together with feature-weighted cycle gun proved to be effective to address the inaccuracy and incompleteness of OpenStreetMap. To scale up the model, we used decentralized parallel training and achieved nearly linear speedup. We will continue to explore more advanced data augmentation measures to further improve the model performance and asynchronized training scheme to further speed up the training. Our final goal is to generate more accurate maps across the US, and we will make them freely available to the public. Finally, thanks for your attention from the team.